Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and a very good afternoon. Kita start dulu dengan ummu kitab Al-Fatihah. Okay. So this June 2016, if we go through this question, actually it's about the same as what we discussed in our class lah, in our lecture last time. Okay, the example that we discussed in the class is about last time is about evaporator lah. Saya tak sure juga, tapi the solution is about the same. Okay, the method to solve. So you have evaporator. But this time it's H2SO4. Alright, so it's to be concentrated. So out of the evaporator, you have concentrated 28%. Okay. And then water. So if you read this water, so water, I guess this is, okay, water content. So the evaporated vapor, okay? So the product is also water vapor, all right? And then it emerged at 70 degrees C and 180 and both of the solution and also the water vapor. So describe the above process in a block diagram. So this is supposed to be your block diagram lah, on top there, evaporator. Okay, so you have your inlet here, 2% of the solution. Your outlet is 20% of the solution, and you have water vapor here. Okay, so you are asked to find the mass flow rate of all streams and mole ratio of solvent to solute. Okay. So I guess the 3 marks for the drawing too is each stream represent 1 mark. Okay, so for the total mass, you know, for the unknown, because you are required to give the mass flow rate. Mass flow rate of all stream. Okay, mass flow rate. So mass flow rate, you do not need to do any conversion yet here. Okay, for A, because mass flow rate. Alright, in fact, the fraction given here, are all in weight percent, so mass. Right, so just a simple solving of the material balance, total mass, H2SO4 balance. So you got the B here and then your A here. Okay. So your A is, if you convert your A to molar flow rate, is 50 mole per minute lah here, this one. Okay. But this conversion mole ni, you can do it later in B. Okay, again in A also you are required to calculate the R. So since I didn't do the conversion here. Okay, so my conversion is here in the R. Okay, my conversion is here. If you want to show this a different way, doesn't matter. If you want to show it earlier before you calculating R, it's also okay. Okay, as long as you change the more mass flow rate into more for it. Okay, but for me, I just show in the calculation of the R. So this is the mass flow rate of the solvent, the molecular weight. So I got this is the mole flow rate. And this is the mass fraction or mass flow rate for the solute H2SO4 and the molecular weight. So I got it here. So this is the R inlet. And for the R outlet, okay, It's actually this formula, this one, actually an optional whether you want to give it or not. Okay, but if you give, then it will be better to give, like I say, because if you wrongly, you know, give a value below this, so at least you got, you still got mark for the method. Method, like we give you mark for the method. Okay, so again here, I give the formula. It's not the formula, like the R formula is very general, kan? Very common for the inlet outlet. And then this is the mole flow rate. The unit also, gram, minute, all that, still optional. You can put it there with the calculation, or you can just ignore the unit as long as it's consistent lah. Okay, if not consistent, then you'll be in trouble lah kan, your value will be wrong. Alright, so this is the conversion to mole for the solvent, and this is for the solute. So you got, this is the outlet. Okay, 21.76. So looking to the R, from 200 to 22 is about 22. So we have less solvent here. Okay, the lesser the R, the smaller the R, your solution is quite concentrated, less water, but it's only 20% you pun. Alright, so next is to calculate the Q. Give your reference state. Okay, as you know, H2SO4, the pure solute adalah in liquid form. Okay, so that's why we put it there lah, H2SO4 and H2O liquid. Alright, and this is the component. H2SO4 aqueous, because it has two different R, so you put it as different column. Okay, and you give the, this is the molar flow rate for the H2SO4 only, and this is also H2SO4 only, because the, your H here, you have heat of solution. So heat of solution uniknya adalah kilojoule per mole H2SO4. So that's why we put S mole of H2SO4 only, not mole of the solution. Okay, so for the first one, the inlet is at 25 degrees C. The outlet is at 70 degrees C. So for the inlet, so you have to mix. So this is the process. You have to mix the H2SO4 liquid with the water at 25 degrees C. Then you produce H2SO4 aqueous at 25 degrees C. So looking to table B11, R of 266.86. So you got as negative 75.12. Okay, and H2 is vapor coming out, same as what as our example. So you have three paths. You need to convert it from liquid to vapor, and then when you calculate, okay, when you calculate, so you have these three. So when you calculate, you get this. This red color is the correct value actually, because the black one, this one, -1.0175, I only consider A and B term only, A and B for the CP. But this value is considering all A, B, C and D term in the CP, in the CP. Okay, but you can see there is no much different. You got the same, it's about the same value lah. Okay, 45.288. All right, for the H2. For H3, okay, 70 degrees C, yeah? So you mix first, and then you increase the solution to 70 degrees C. Okay, so as given in the question, you go back to the question. Consider heat capacity for H2SO4 solution as solute component. Solute component. Okay, solute component. So solute component, solute is H2SO4 liquid. Okay, so this is the CP for H2SO4 liquid. Okay, this value. But we assume it to be CP for the H2SO4 aqueous. Right, so that's why I write it here, H2SO4 aqueous. Okay. So be careful with that if you are, because H2SO4 is liquid, eh? And then the liquid is available in table B2. Okay. So don't just simply use Cobb's rule. Eh? Don't just simply use Cobb's rule. See first in the table in B2. If not there, then you can assume if it is liquid or solid lah. Okay. So when you do that, okay, the black color is actually my old answer, which is quite wrong. So the new one is this right? This is the 6.593 is this value actually, but previously I assume it to be kilojoule per mole H2SO4, but now it's actually kilojoule per mole solution. So I need to multiply with the solution flow rate and divide by the H2SO4 flow rate. Okay, I didn't put the unit, the minute, because the minute will be cancelled lah. Alright, so I didn't put it there. Then I get 78.94. Okay, so quite a bit different between the old one, negative 64. Now is 78.94. Now last is solving the Q, then you write the energy balance lah. You write the energy balance and put all, then you got this. So the final value is not that much different lah, because this only represent of 0.204, so not that much. Okay, so you've got 2295.8 kilojoule per minute. Any questions so far? I'm sure many of you haven't tried this. And I would say, during this ODL, online learning, we never ask question on mixing solution. And I'm thinking of giving this question in your, not sure, in your assignment, in your test. Still thinking of that. So far, the last two semester, we never ask question on this. Okay, because this is very straightforward question. We can't make it complicated. Okay, so let us see lah. I'm not sure whether I will put this question, this topic in the assignment or not. All right, so next we go to the second question. It seems quite easy actually, but last time during face-to-face, many of the students are not able to solve B here, the amount of the water liquid. They are not able to get that. Or they, I don't know, okay? It's very simple, looking to the question, it's very simple, but this question, you need to recall your chapter 5 of the folder, chapter gases, vapors, liquid, STP, standard temperature pressure. And then also here, the specific gravity, the CP. So this specific gravity and CP, since it is in the bracket here, so it refer to the solution. Okay, it refer to the solution. So means the specific gravity of the solution, the CP of the solution. So the CP of the solution is already given here. Okay, so no need to do any assumption. All right, so you want to prepare the solution, you add this 2,500 liter of HCl gas, the solute, in liquid water at 40 degrees C. And then your basis is 10 liter per minute of the HCl solution. Okay, so if you draw. Okay, so this is the drawing. So the one looking in B, you are required to calculate this A. Okay, you have 2,500 liter STP of HCl gas, because in liquid gas form, and then you have water liquid 40 degrees C. This one your product, the aqueous 10 liter per minute. The specific gravity is given there. All right, so what to do to calculate A? First, you from the information given, 10 liter per minute volumetric flow rate. To convert the volumetric flow rate to mass flow rate, you need to use density. So the density is given by this specific gravity, where this specific gravity is actually rho over rho reference. So rho reference, if I take a kilogram per meter cube, it will be 1000. Okay, so that's why I put it here, 1190, I multiply with 1000 because my raw reference is 1000 or 1 centimeter per cent, you know, 1 gram per centimeter cube or 62 something in pound mass. Itu tak perlu ingat lah, no need to remember that one. You can go into the conversion table there, conversion table. Okay. All right, so from there, this is only conversion from liter to meter cube. So you've got 11.9 kilogram per minute. Okay, so the question asks you to identify the amount of water unitnya is mole per minute. The unit is mole per minute. Okay, mole per minute. All right, so 11.9 kilogram per meter of the outlet. This is the outlet. Okay, the outlet. Now, looking to the information given, 2,500 liter STP. Okay, so this is a standard given in the table of chapter 5. So you got it. Sorry, this is not meter cube. This is mole supposed to be. Okay, 111.53 mole per minute. Okay, all right. So you see here, you from this calculation so far, the outlet is in mass flow rate. The inlet is in mole flow rate. For sure, to make it easy, okay, to make it easy, or for sure, we will convert this to mole, right? We will convert this to mole per minute, so that we can subtract this value with the outlet to get A in mole per minute. But I would like to ask you, can you convert this 11.9 kilogram per minute to mole per minute with the information given so far? Are you able to convert this to mole per minute? This is very fundamental lah, your CPP 1. Are you able to convert this to mole per minute, 11.9? Anybody? Nobody dare to answer. Okay, this is I would say the mistake made by previous students. Okay, I don't know how they convert the 11.9 kilogram per minute to mole per minute. Okay, looking to the answer, there are many answers, kan? I guess one of the answer that I can remember, how they convert from kilogram to minute, to mole, they add the molecular weight of HCl and water. They divide this to 36.47 plus water is what, 18. Then they got mole per minute, which is totally wrong. Okay, because this one, okay, again, as I mentioned, this is a very fundamental of your CPP1, your metric balance. You need to consider the composition of your compound. Then only you can do, remember the average molecular weight, average molecular weight. So average molecular weight, this is not average molecular weight. Adding 2 divided by 2, let's say like you divide by 2, this is not average molecular weight. So average molecular weight, you need to have the mole fraction and the molecular weight, right? For A, and then mole fraction of B with molecular weight of B. So you do not know the fraction, the mass fraction, the mole fraction of your outlet. So since then, you cannot convert lah. You cannot convert the unit from kilogram per minute. So what to do? Okay, what to do? As shown here, I convert the HCl gas flow rate to mass flow rate because I'm able to convert it to mass flow rate because I only have one HCl gas, the only one component, so I have 100% of HCl gas in that stream. Okay, so I convert it to mass flow rate, and then I calculate the find the mass flow rate of the water A. Okay, inlet equal to outlet. And then I convert the mesh fluoride obtained here to mol fluoride. Okay, this is just you know, a simple fundamental lah, but yet most of the student they make a mistake of the here lah, as I mentioned here, this one they convert this to mol. Okay, wrongly convert that to mol. So now the mol fluoride of the water is 435 mol per minute, and the concentration is already given in the question. The formula is mol HCl per liter solution. So mol HCl already been calculated earlier, 111.53. This is the outlet concentration of HCl, because HCl concentration refer to the aqueous lah. Okay, for sure it refer to the aqueous. It's not referring to the HCl gas. And this is the 10 liter solution. Okay, you should have minute per minute lah, but the minute cancel. So you got 11.15. This is very clear cut. So next, for the Q, your reference state, HCl gas, water at 25 degrees C, 180 m. So you put all this. Okay, now we go to H1. H1 is only increase the temperature from 25 to 30. Okay, so from there you calculate, you got 0.15. And then for the H2 is only increasing the temperature from 25 to 40, no phase change, all that. So you got 1.131. And lastly, for the solution, you need to find the R. And looking to table B11, you got -60.765. And then you integrate 2.43. This is, remember, this is CP for the solution, and the unit is actually kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin. Okay, so this kilogram refer to kilogram solution. Kelvin, okay, you should actually, for the conversion, you should 2.43 multiply with 50 plus 273 minus 25 plus 273. So for only one term of the CP, then you can just simply put the degree Celsius, no change. But if you have power 50 square, okay, for 50 square degree C, you need to change this to Kelvin first lah, if it is Kelvin. Okay, but for only 50 minus 25, then it will be the same, man. Okay, because the range or the difference in Celsius Kelvin is the same. So you got -54.285 SH3, and then you give the energy balance, and this is the Q obtained, -65.63.12. So tally with the question saying that you need to transfer an amount of Q from the absorption tower. Absorption tower, yes. Okay. So can I proceed? Okay. All right, so the last question, December 15. Okay, so December 15 ni pun, the tricky, there is a tricky there, because looking to this value, okay, the 5000 is very clear, is the flow of the solid sodium hydroxide. Now the 8000 mol per liter. Look, reading the statement here, sodium hydroxide solution with 8000 mol per hour of sodium hydroxide and the balanced water leave the second tank at 45 degrees C. So if you look to the drawing, okay, so the mistake made by the previous student is this one. This 8000 only refer to the NaOH, not referring to the D. Okay, so be careful with that. Okay, not referring to D, it's refer to the NaOH in the solution. Okay, and then if you look into my drawing, my unknown here, my unknown all in kilogram per hour, because here this is weight percent, not mole percent. Okay, so that's why normally for heat and solution, mixing solution ni, they tend to, you know, mix the unit of the compound, some in mole per hour, some in mass per hour. Okay, because no other tricky can be made. Okay, so the tricky is just that on that mixing of units lah, mix of unit. Okay, so you have here weight percent, here is mole per hour, here also mole per hour. So if you look to my solution, if I go to the question, you are only asked to solve the metric balance for both mixing tanks. No specific unit, whether in mass, okay, whether in mole per hour or whether in gram per hour, is nowhere mentioned there. So I can choose any. Okay, so for me, I mean in kilogram per hour. Okay, I mean in kilogram per hour. Wait, kilogram eh? Saya rasa macam salah ni, gram eh? Wait, kilogram lah, kilogram. Yes, I already convert it to kilogram. Divide by 1,000. Wait. Salah ni kan? I guess it's 1,000 gram. Yes, 1,000 gram. Yes, the value is correct because you got it at 1 million, then divide by 1,000, so you got 1,000 kilogram. Yes, it's kilogram per hour. It's correct. Okay, and then if I do H2O balance, I got it at 800 kilogram per hour. Okay, if you want to convert this, because it's not mentioned there, if you want to convert this to mole per hour or kilo mole per hour, this one, this also to kilo mole per hour, then you can go ahead with that. It's just that for this case, the answer, no, the mark for that calculation should be in B. Should be in B. Okay, looking to my solution ni, I will give you marks for that conversion in B, not in A. Okay. Alright, so next is on mixer 2, because you are asked to solve the metric balance. Eh? Solve the metric balance. So what do you mean by solve the metric balance? Looking to my drawing, what do I mean by solve the metric balance? I need to get to calculate A, B, C, D, all the unknowns. All the unknowns. 5,000 mole per hour, if you maintain that, then okay, because it's also flow rate. Okay, it's also flow rate. Alright, so looking to the drawing, so you need to draw it correctly lah. Okay, so if you draw it correctly, then your A, B, C, D should be the answer of your soft metric balance. Okay, so you should calculate A, B, C, D. So later, I'm using mixer 2 boundary. If I want to do overall boundary, still okay. You still can, you should be able to solve overall boundary. Yes. As long as you got the A, okay. But now I'm using mixer 2 boundary. So I got C 120 and D 1120 kilogram per hour. Okay. So for this one, for the energy, for the Q, so this is the reference state. So this 5,000 is already given in the question. This 5,000 is also already given. So this is the one I should calculate. Okay. The Q is, you are required to calculate Q for the mixer 1 only. Eh? Mixer 1. Okay, mixer 1. So you only consider mixer 1. Eh? No need to consider mixer 2. Okay, mixer 1. So this one, H2O in the of the mixer 1 is 4444.4. This is what A tadi, 800 ni. 800. So I show the conversion here. I showed a conversion here. So if you already show this conversion in A, then the mark will be given in B lah. Okay, still can be accepted lah. Okay, as long as you show. But if you do not show this, you just give 4, 4, 4, 4, 4 without showing any conversion, then you cannot get full mark. Okay, you have to show. All right. This one 5,000 no need lah because it's already there. And so those already in the question, then you do not need to show. Those you need to do calculation, then you have to show. So for the water is 4,444. Then you need to find H1, H2. So H1, H2 since it is at 25 degrees C, so it's zero because reference date. All right. So for H3, the outlet of the mixer one. Okay, so I need to do some conversion here. Okay, the solvent, the solute. So I got it here, 8.89. Looking to table B11, I got negative 41.45. And as mentioned there in the question, take the capacity, heat capacity of sodium hydroxide solution as pure water. So I get this value from the pure water liquid and then integrate from 25 to 40 and then convert because this is mole solution. So I convert into kilomole. Okay. So this kilomole will be cancelled out although I put in more here. Okay. So the final is negative 30.27. So when you write the energy balance and solve it, you got negative 1.5. So the mixer release an amount of negative 1.5 to the power of 10 to the power of 5 kilojoule per hour of Q in order for the mixing to occur. Okay. So that's all for today. Any questions? No questions?
No, doctor.
No, maybe. It's very straightforward, right, maybe?
Yeah.
I would say it's very straightforward. It's just that, as I mentioned, the tricky is only on that, the units use. Okay. So I'm still thinking whether I want to ask this question in again because the limitation of data lah. All right. So if no question, then I stop here. Next week we will be revision week because we already covered the syllabus for chapter 8, a non-reactive. So next week, I guess I will discuss questions related to chapter 7 and 8. An example of previous final assessment and assignment. Okay, first time ever. Okay, I will discuss the question with all of you. ODL. Last semester, I never discussed this ODL to the student.
Okay.
Boleh je nanti akak buka.